Every woodworker knows their shop is their personal space, and that space is a constant work in process. If you're looking for shop organization, storage, and layout tips, keep watching because I'll show you exactly how I do it. I'll show you the tools I use as well as my workflow that help make this space work for me. Also, I'm going to leave links in the description for a lot of the tools that I use, as well as build videos and plans available for a lot of the things that you're going to see. So make sure that you check that out. Now let's get started. First things first, let's talk about the shop layout. My shop occupies the third bay of my garage and goes most of the way under my house. It's divided into two rooms. The front of the shop is 25 feet by 16 feet, and it's where I process sheet goods, break down lumber, and do final assembly. The back room is slightly smaller at 28 feet by 12 feet, and this room is where all my bigger milling tools live, as well as my dust collector and all my lumber storage. Every project begins right here in the front of the shop because I can bring sheet goods and lumber in through the garage door behind me and begin breaking it down right in this area. Now, just off camera is my table saw and my miter saw, but you often see me using a centipede work holder and a piece of styrofoam insulation to break down sheet goods right in this area. It's so easy and convenient, I can back the truck right up to the garage door and slide my sheet goods right onto the centipede and begin breaking them into manageable chunks using my track saw. I also keep my MFT table up here again for breaking plywood down into final dimensions, and I have a flip top tool cart which has two different sanders on it. This is one of the most handy tools to have in my shop and one of the few things that I have left that came with me over from my old two-car garage shop at my last house. Another thing that roams around this part of the shop is my shop vac dust collection cart. Now this is a super handy tool when it comes to small hand tools as well as sanders, but I also like to use it just to sweep up my shop after a project. It wheels around nice and easy. It's only about a 2 foot square footprint, so it stores out of the way, doesn't take up much room, and it's made out of about a half a sheet of 3/4 inch plywood, so it doesn't take much material to make. Now I do have plans for this on my website. If you want to look into building one of these yourself, I'll go ahead and leave a link in the description below. One of the biggest upgrades I made to my shop last year is actually what's behind me right now, and that's my garage door. Last year, my old garage door motor burned out on me, and instead of just replacing that, I decided to do something even better. In order to create more headroom in this part of the shop, I ended up raising the rails almost to the ceiling, and I also switched over to a side mount garage door motor. The net result is that I've got about 2 feet extra headroom space directly above my work area. That's something you don't think about a lot until you go to move a board around and you hit the garage door rail or the motor. Now, this isn't an upgrade that you will notice much while you're watching my videos, but trust me, working in this area, this upgrade was a big improvement to my workflow. Another thing I wanted to show you here in the front of the shop is a small jig wall. This is just a piece of pegboard hung on 2x4s, and I keep my sleds and other jigs here. Easy to see, easy to access when I need to use them. It's super handy, but it's much smaller than it used to be, and the reason for that is what I'm going to show you next. But before we dive into that, I did want to mention one thing that happened in 2021, and that is I hit 100,000 subscribers to the channel. That's huge. I'm so grateful for all the folks that helped me get to that milestone, and at the end of the video, I have one more shop upgrade to make, so keep watching for that. The biggest upgrade I made to my shop last year was replacing my old miter saw cart with this amazing new miter saw station. A whopping 14 feet of storage and organization. This wall was only being used for wood storage and not much else was going on here. It was really a poor use of space. Now I have 5 base cabinets and 4 upper cabinets and a lot more storage. With 8 feet of counter space to the left of the saw and 4 feet to the right, I can cut full length boards with full support. I installed T-track and measuring tape along both sides of the saw, and I also made these custom stop blocks that are rock solid to help me make accurate and repeatable cuts at my new station. These cabinets are full of new ways to organize my tools and supplies. I added pull-out trays to maximize storage capacity and accessibility, and I also added this slide-out saw blade storage system to keep all my blades organized and in a very small footprint. I even have all my bits, drivers, and fasteners completely organized in these drawers so I can easily grab what I need, take it to my project, and then return it when I'm done. The upper cabinets are great for holding all my sanding supplies as well as my finishes, and I also have these plastic bins to hold other items so I can grab and go when I need to. Another thing I badly needed was easier access to power in this part of the shop, so I added 3 outlets along the miter station to give me better access to power when I need it. I do have plans available to build the full miter saw station with all the storage options, and I'll leave that link in the description down below. But if you just want to build upper cabinets or lower cabinets, I also sell plans for those individually at a lesser cost. Now, the beautiful thing about these cabinets is they're high enough quality that you can put them in your kitchen or your pantry if you don't want to use them as shop cabinets. Along this wall is where I keep my clamps. I've got racks for my small clamps as well as my large pipe clamps and parallel clamps. All the assembly I do in my shop is done right here in this area, so these clamps are right where they need to be, easy to grab and use in all of my projects. Now right next to the clamp is a cabinet that kind of became obsolete once I built my miter saw station, but today I use it for patterns that I use for my router as well as other jigs and accessories. And right below that is my tool chest, and this is where I keep all of my non-woodworking tools. Things like pliers, screwdrivers, hammers, wrenches, things of that nature that I use for other projects around the house end up in this tool chest. To finish off this wall, I've got my drill charging station. I've got places for chargers as well as all my cordless drivers and bit storage down below. Now right smack dab in the middle of the shop is my biggest and most important tool, and that is my table saw. I've got a SawStop 3 horsepower cabinet saw, and I use this thing on just about every project that comes to the shop, so it is right perfectly placed where it needs to be. And I've got a nice large outfeed slash assembly table on the other end of it. Now I did want to forget talking about what's overhead of me here, and that is my air cleaner. Now this really takes care of all the super fine particles, the really tiny stuff that can float in the air and get in our lungs and mess up our health. And it's one of the most important parts of my dust collection strategy. The big cyclone takes care of all the chips and really does a good job of collecting stuff at the source, but you can never get all of it and you need something to back you up and make sure that you're staying good and safe when it comes to breathing in dust in the shop. This model is made by Powermatic and it looks different than your typical box style air cleaners. The first thing I like about it is how quiet it is. When I have this thing on full blast, you barely notice that it's on. Even on camera, you really can't hear it. So it stays in the background, nice and quiet above me, protecting the air quality of my shop while I work. Now in the side of my table saw, I did build a router table. Now this is really a relic from my old two-car garage shop where I needed to conserve space by combining tools into one unit. It did have storage space for router bits as well as table saw blades and other table saw accessories, as well as a viewing window here where you could see into the router, and that router is on an Incra lift. I don't really use this much anymore because I've got another router table over there, which we'll talk about in a minute. But I do use this one on occasion where I've got situations where I need to run a larger workpiece and I need much more support so I can leverage my table saw surface to support my work across the bit. When I moved from my two-car garage to this new workshop, I gained a lot of working space and I wanted to utilize that workspace by creating dedicated workstations. And so I added this woodpecker router table and fence system. But one of the biggest pet peeves I have in my shop is having tools with wasted space underneath. This table came with a basic metal stand, but no storage at all. So I decided to turn this router table into a router station with enough storage to fit every router, accessory, and bit that I own. Now I have everything related to routers in one place and it all fits into the same footprint as before, but with no wasted space. Above the router station, I've got all of my squares and other marking and measuring tools, easy to access and in one place. And right next to that is probably my all-time favorite shop project that I've ever done, and that is my hand tool cabinet. This is something that I built using plans from Fine Woodworking Magazine. I think Mike Pekovich is the one that designed and built this, but it is absolutely beautiful. I keep all of my vintage hand planes and all of the other hand tools that I have in one cabinet. Now one day I plan on building a proper hand tool workbench that's gonna go right here in this area of the shop. And that's why I keep these on the wall here. This cabinet is perfectly placed for that point in time when I do hand tool work in the shop. Now tucked away in this corner of my shop is my drill press. I have a benchtop model and it sits on this old cart that I brought from my two-car garage shop. Now in 2022, I will be doing some big project around the drill press to add a proper cart and some other accessories that are gonna maximize the functionality of my drill press, so stay tuned for that. And behind me, I've just got a storage cabinet where I keep random jigs and other items that I want to keep stored and out of the way that I don't use that often. But down below, I wanted to make sure that I mentioned this dust port that comes through the wall. This is how I feed dust collection to my table saw, my router table, my drill press. And that goes through the wall and to the dust collector, which is in the other room, and that's where we're going next. All right, now here we are in the backside of the shop, and the first thing that I wanted to show you was my shop locker. Now, this is just a really tall cabinet that I built, but what I keep in here is my PPE, my first aid kit, my shop aprons, and some work boots, all in one central location so I know where to find everything, and it's nice and organized and out of the way, and this nice big door keeps everything dust-free. Now, right next to that, I have my CNC machine. Now, this is not something that I use often on the channel. You don't see this a lot in my work, but it is something that I use a lot in my projects when I need to batch a bunch of things out or get some really high accuracy on some parts that I'm making for projects. I do utilize that machine a lot. I would like to use CNC and CNC type work on the channel more often, so I am curious to find out what types of things you guys would like to see me do on the CNC. If that's content that you would be interested in seeing, please leave some comments down below to let me know what you would like me to do with that. It is something that I would like to expand on more on my channel. And across from the CNC machine is where I keep my rack with all my Festool gear, easy to access, and the sustainers when I need to grab and go. And right next to that is my lathe and my lathe stand. Now, I'm not going to spend too much time talking about this because honestly, I don't turn that often. I do have a smaller lathe that can be expanded in capacity if I ever need it. And it does sit on this nice stout lathe stand that's got plenty of storage below for all the turning tools and accessories, as well as some storage over here for turning blanks. Now, the main thing that I use this back room for is it holds most of my larger power tools, starting with my bandsaw. This is a 14-inch Laguna bandsaw. Right next to that, I've got my drum sander. Now, I don't really use my drum sander very often anymore, unless I am sanding in grain or figured wood. I use it for that. Otherwise, it just sits there parked in this corner of the shop. Now, the other two tools that I have in this part of my shop are my big milling machines. I've got my 15-inch Grizzly planer and my 8-inch Grizzly jointer sitting back here next to my dust collector. Now, if you're new to woodworking, you're probably not into these big milling machines yet, but that's okay because you can buy pre-surfaced lumber at the big box store or local hardwood dealer, but you're eventually going to want to get into buying rough sawn lumber because it's cheaper and more widely available. I've been using these Grizzly models now for about 7 years. I love them both. They're very reliable. They're not the most expensive machines that you can buy, but they get the job done well. Now, back here in the corner of the shop is where I keep my dust collection beast. This is a huge Oneida Dust Gorilla Cyclone, and it is one of the best investments I have made in this shop. Now, I say this shop on purpose because I have a very unique situation in how narrow and long my shop is. From this dust collector all the way through the wall to my table saw is almost 50 feet, and I need a 3-horsepower machine with a big 6-inch trunk line to be able to get good, efficient dust collection at some of my most messy tools up there in the front of the shop. Now, your dust collection situation might be different in your shop. Your layout might not require something this large, but if you are looking to upgrade your dust collection, I can recommend these Oneida dust collectors. They are just about the best in the business, in my opinion, and they really get the job done well here in my shop. If you saw my last shop tour video, you saw me confess to being a wood hoarder. But when I built my miter saw station, I really wanted to do a good job of consolidating and rationalizing all of my lumber storage into the shop into something a little less shameful. So here's the result of that, and I think I did a pretty good job of doing that. Over here on the right, I've got my lumber storage rack. So all of the large pieces of lumber that come in from the lumber dealer go up here, safely out of the way and easy to get at when I need them. Back behind me is my offcut bin. So this is where I keep all the stuff that's too small to go on the lumber rack, but still needs a place to live, all organized so I can thumb through it and pick out what I need. And over here on my left, I built some bins for all of my smaller offcuts. So these would be things like for small scrap wood projects or cutting boards. I keep those all in one place here. And right next to that, what little plywood scrap that I have lives there. So 1, 2, 3, I've got everything located right where I need it in an organized way, and I think that I've got my lumber situation under control. All right, everybody, as I mentioned earlier, there is one more shop upgrade that I wanted to talk about in this video, and this one is huge. It's this guy right here, the silver play button that I received for hitting 100,000 subscribers to the channel. Big, huge milestone. Thank you again so much for coming along with me on this journey and supporting the channel. I literally could not have done this without you guys. So thanks so much. And this guy's gonna live right here on the wall, right next to the logo, so that every time I'm in the shop working on a project, I'll have a constant reminder of you guys helping me hit this milestone on the channel. So thanks again so much, and that's it. You guys did this, not me.